It is also the father of Allah that we are in this group. What is this group? 50-50. Comes Ramzan, we become very pious. Comes the day of Eid, again we back to square one. Suddenly we decide to go in Jamaat. So the body language changes, style changes. We go in Jamaat 40 days, mashallah. We come back for about 3-4 weeks. And then again back to square one. So up and down. 50-50. Sometimes very pious, sometimes very filthy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَوَّلُهُ rahmatun. The first 10 days are full of rahmat. First 10 days full of rahmat. That means those people who are pure from sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the very first day sends rahmat upon them. Rahmat. Because they don't need maghfirat. They don't need maghfirat. Rahmat. And for those who are 50-50, the middle group, the third group, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, look, 50-50, that means five and a half months sinful life and five and a half months good life. So I'm not asking too much from you. Just spend your time properly in the first 10 days. First 10 days. And comes the 11th day, وَأَوْسَتُهُ مَغْفِرَةٌ, I will forgive your sins. 5.5 months of sins I will forgive you by, if you only look after yourself for 10 days of Ramadan. And the third group, which is full of filth, if they were to die now, they would go straight to the fire of Jahannam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you'll have to work a little bit more harder. 10 more days. And comes the 21st day, itkum minan nar, I will give you deliverance from the fire of Jahannam. So my friends, let us go from this here with a very, very firm resolution that this Ramadan is going to be different from all the other Ramadan. The first thing I would like to urge all of you to do is to make yourself feel guilty. Guilty for what? Guilty for wasting all the Ramadan that have passed. If you make yourself feel guilty, then you will be able to appreciate this Ramadan. So make yourself feel guilty and make a firm resolution that this Ramadan is going to be different. How different? Number one, I am not going to waste a single second. And number two, I am not going to commit any sin. There is going to be a lot of recitation of the Quran. As mixing as less as possible. Because when we mix, we talk about this person and that person. Ghibat starts, sin starts. People distract us from our ibadat. Focus only towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and akhirah. Pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Him to make you, all of us, the wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My late sheikh and mentor, Hazrat Haji Farooq Sahib rahmatullahi alayhi, said to me on numerous occasions, and he used to say to other people also, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you who believe, kutiba alaykumus siyam. The fasting of the month of Ramadan has been made compulsory upon you, كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ, just as it was made compulsory upon the people before you, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so that you become muttaqi, so that you become the wali of Allah. Muttaqi is the wali of Allah, so that you become the friend of Allah. So my late Haji Sahib Rahmatullahi Alayhi used to say that when you make dua, say to Allah that, O Allah, you have made fasting compulsory, you have granted us the month of Ramadan so that we may become walis. This is why you made the month of Ramadan, so make me wali. You have made this month of Ramadan to make us muttaqi, make me muttaqi, Allah. It is only you who can change my life. I have become slave to my nafs, I have become slave to my shaitan, Allah, you help me. And become helpless in the court of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes humbleness very much. When a person goes to the court of Allah and he says, Oh Allah, I am helpless. It is only you who can save me. It is only you who can give me this love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your love. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help. So let us make a firm resolution, inshallah, that this month of Ramadan that is coming. And we need to start changing from today. We need to start changing from today. Because in order for your car to go in the fifth gear, you can never put your car in the fifth gear from the place you start moving. So you have to put it start and then first gear and then second gear and then third gear and then fourth gear and then fifth gear. So if you wait until the first of Ramadan, then by the time your car comes into the fifth gear, it will be 11th of Ramadan. So you need to start from today. So if you start from today, then inshallah by the time Ramadan starts, your car will be in fifth gear. So what we need to do is to change our lifestyle slightly from today. First thing is no sins. Second thing is no wasting time. And become punctual with our amal, with our ma'amulat. And then as soon as first of Ramadan comes in, we increase our ma'amulat, we increase our amal. And set targets. In order to become successful, we have to set targets. If you continue to recite the Quran, you may complete two Qurans. But if you set target, that every day I must recite five juz every day. If you said, every day I must recite Durood Sharif 500 times. Every day I must recite Istighfar. Every day before the breaking of fast, I must turn to Allah for 10-15 minutes and ask Him for my needs of this world and the hereafter. Every day at Tahajjud time, at least for 15 minutes, I must turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And please take a copy of Prophet from Ramadan and study it properly. It's a small booklet published by the Islamic Dawah Academy. And also try to begin to read Fada'il Ramadan by Shaykh al-Hadith Muhammad Zakariya Sahib rahmatullahi alayhi. In the Masajid, it is being read now. Fada'il Ramadan. It will be read in the month of Ramadan as well. Try to listen to it. And also try to sit down as a family from now. So that mentally you start preparing for the month of Ramadan. Try to sit down as a family at home and read Fada'il Amal by Shaykh al-Hadith Mawlana Zakariya Sahib rahmatullahi alayhi. And try to connect yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم احفظنا من كل بلاء الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم أصلح لنا شأننا كله ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين ولا تنزع منا صالح ما آتيتنا وارحم الراحمين have mercy upon us وارحم الراحمين forgive our sins forgive our minor sins forgive our major sins forgive the sins of our parents forgive the sins of our families Forgive the sins of all those who are associated to us. Forgive the sins of those who are living. Forgive the sins of our deceased. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us the tawfiq to repent sincerely. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us the tawfiq to repent sincerely. O Arhamur Rahimeen, accept our repentance and keep us steadfast on our repentance. O Arhamur Rahimeen, save us from shaitan and our base desires. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us the tawfiq to live according to your wishes. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us the tawfiq to keep away from everything that displeases you. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us the tawfiq to stay away from everything that displeases you. O Arhamur Rahimeen, majority of the times we are doing those things which displease you. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us the opportunity to make you happy and grant us the opportunity to do those things in life which are desirable to you and which is according to your wishes. O Arhamur Rahimeen, for as long as we live in this world, keep us steadfast on Iman, keep us steadfast on Islam. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us the tawfiq to strive towards keeping your other servants on straight path also. And O Arhamur Rahimeen, when you take us from this world, take us with Iman. O Allah, safeguard our Iman. O Allah, protect our Iman. O Arhamur Rahimeen, save us from the deceit of shaitan at the time of death. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us lot of barakah in the days of Shaban that are passing. Make these days full of barakah for us. And O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us the tawfiq to benefit from the month of Ramadan. O Arhamur Rahimeen, make this year's Ramadan a turning point in our lives. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us all and grant all of our associates, our parents, our wives, our families, our friends, those associated to us, the whole ummah. Ilaha al-Alamin, grant us all the opportunity in this month of Ramadan to become your awliya. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us your wilayat. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us your love. O Arhamur Rahimeen, grant us your nearness. O Arhamur Rahimeen, fulfill all the good wishes of this world and the hereafter. O Arhamur Rahimeen, safeguard us from every evil of this world and the hereafter. O Arhamur Rahimeen, All the good things that your Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has asked from you, grant us all those good things. And every evil from which your Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has seeked refuge, grant us refuge. رَبِّ جَعَلْنِي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي رَبَّنَا وَتَقَبَّلْ دُعَى رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْحِسَابُ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ وَارْحَمْ وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الرَّاحِمِينَ سُبْحَانَ رَبِّكَ رَبِّ الْعِزَّةِ عَمَّا يَصِفُونَ وَسَلَامٌ عَلَى الْمُرْسَلِينَ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.